Yeah, everyone, how are you going? It's Josh here from Blackfoot Fitness, and I've got a little helper in the kitchen this morning, Malia, and she's going to help us, or help me go through and create some native flower scones, also with a bit of emu bush, just add that medicinal aspect to the meal. So before I begin, I just want to pay my respects to the Wattle people, the Wattle Nation that we're going to do this cook up on today, and also a shout out to Barbara Peachy, who sort of gave me a bit of inspiration to start adding some things into the traditional scone that I've been making recently. So before we begin and we start playing with all the food, it's really important to wash our hands. So we'll go ahead and do that right now, and then we'll come back and we'll start preparing these native plants that I have here. Okay, so let's go. All right, so our hands are all washed. We're good to go and start preparing our flowers. I'll just go through them and just show you what I have. So we've got some bottle brush. Okay, we went and picked these today. We've got some bottle brush, the red flower. We've got some eucalyptus leaves that are flowering at the moment. We've got some pig face, okay, big flower, tasty flower. Also get a good smell out of that. And the medicinal plant that we're gonna use today is the emu bush. And we're gonna use that just to add a medicinal spice to it. Okay, we're gonna grind that up in a minute. I might get you to do that, okay, mate? Mm-hmm. All right, so I'll go and chop this sort of stuff up. What I'll get you to do is, can I get you to just pull the leaves off? Pull them all off. Okay, so we don't want the stem, so we just want the leaves in there for you to grind up, okay? So once you finish with that, you can probably just chuck that over here on that plate, okay? Mm-hmm. All right, you go through and get that done, and I'll go through and start getting our flowers ready. And it's a beautiful time at the moment. Spring all around the country, so all the native flowers are really showing off. Around parts of the country, especially here on Wattle country, along the river, the Macquarie River, one of the three rivers that run through or over Wattle country. So there's lots of different native flowers going there. You're done already, mate.
Yep.
Flying. All right, what I'll get you to do now is, just want to pick up the rest of those little ones, pick up those, and then put them back in. When you're ready and you've got all them, mate, you can grab this and just start to grind leaves down.
Yeah.
Nice, that's grinding down very good, mate. Well done, okay. Get it nice and as fine as you can, so we can just mix it in with the flour that we're going to use. We're also going to add some wattle seed. Sorry, I didn't mention that at the start. We've got some roasted wattle seed. Okay, so it's really fine stuff. And to help get that traditional rise that we get when we're cooking or baking, we're going to use the old black and gold self-raising flour. So we'll get that sorted in a minute. I'll just go through and get the rest of these flowers sorted. What I might get you to do now, mate, is have a go at these little eucalyptus flowers. So we've got to be very careful, okay? So we want to just try and pick the flower off. So that we're not going to get much, but we're still going to get a little bit. Okay, we might get that that gum sensation of the eucalyptus. So what I'll get you to do is try not to grab these ones. Okay, just grab these little yellow flowers off. You're gonna get these little bits. Okay, and just sprinkle them onto the pig face for me. Slicing and dicing or chopping these flowers down a little bit just so they can mix well with our wattle seed, the emu bush, and also the self-raising flower once we get up to that stage. May actually helped me pick these flowers this morning when we went on our walk, hey, May?
Mm-hmm.
It's pretty cold. It's cold out here in Dubbo at the moment. It's I think it's snowing over in Bathurst or Orange, so we're always lucky when that happens and we get the cold wind that blows over.
Mm-hmm.
And it's the first day of school holidays, mate? Or second? Or it's first week of school holidays?
The first week.
First week. You wouldn't know, mate, because you guys we've been in lockdown out here in Dubbo for a couple of months and it sort of feels like holidays already, hey, just staying at home.
Mm-hmm.
We'll do a couple more and then I'll start to cut these up, mate. I'll get you to do your measurements of the butter. May's helped me before with these scones, so she knows what she's doing. She's starting to become a pro at them. I'll get your butter out there. Thanks for grinding that emu bush down. All right, just chop that in. Good, all right, beauty. Before we begin, you want to tell everyone what you're doing with the butter. Nice loud voice for us.
So we're gonna put the butter on a plate and measure 80 grams.
80 grams of butter, okay. And I'll go through So there's your butter, the butter. And how many grams, mate?
80 grams.
Beautiful. I'll just these flours up a little bit.
There.
80 grams?
Mm-hmm.
All right, beauty. All right, so see how this goes. Do you reckon you'll be able to pour it into there, mate?
Mm-hmm.
Like this?
Yep.
Don't worry if you spill a little bit. That's it. So there's one. Sifting the flour just to help break it up. Alright, so this is the acacia roasted wattle. Alright, so the seeds of the acacia tree. Wattle, flour, seeds of flour. We'll probably use about that much. We'll go about there. This is our first time doing it, so I'm sort of freestyling it here. We know how to cook our scones, but adding all this native material or native ingredients is a first, so we're going to give it a go and see how it goes. Alright, so while May's doing the last of the flour, I've got the wattle seed here and I've got emu bush that we've just grounded up, okay? And I'm just going to add that in here. So the emu bush is really good for any skin conditions, stomach health, oral health. Alright, it's a very, very, very good and well-known medicinal product. So we've sifted the flour with the emu bush and the wattle seed here. We've got our flours all chopped up, ready to go. We're now going to add it in and start mixing it all together. Here we go. All right, so just mix it around, just softly and gently. But when she does that, we'll add the flours after she adds the butter, because the butter kind of makes a breadcrumb texture once it's all mixed in. Now you know what to do here, don't you?
Mm-hmm.
Time to get dirty. If you're going to do this at home, when you are squeezing the butter, try and squeeze it nice and tight so it filters through each of your fingers. So what we're going to do next is add
milk.
Milk is just making it well in the middle of the texture that May has just made. So I'll add these in, May, and I'll just move them and I'll mix it around so you don't have to wash your hands twice as well once we get... There's the well. May's already got my milk ready. What we're going to do now, and what May's going to do now is she's going to slowly stir and continue to stir in that well, and bits and pieces from outside the well are going to fall in. And if I need to, I'll add some more milk as we go. It's just kind of a step-by-step process to mix it all in. So start to give it a bit more stronger. That's it, touch the edge of the sides of the edge.
I reckon a fork would be better.
Yeah. Be a bit harder, so just get, there we go. Yep, so get going like that. Good, 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 good. Okay, it's gonna get a little bit more pasty. When it starts to get pasty, just come off the edges, okay? Because we don't need any more powder, so keep going. So we've already got all the native stuff mixed in just to help finish off the blend before we put it into the oven. And to make sure it's right, we'll just keep adding self-raising flour to finish it off. That's it. Yep. And there's one. I'll probably get about 10 to 12 out of this mix that we've used. We used probably, I think it was 5 or 6 cups.
It was 5 cups.
5 cups of self-raising flour. Probably used maybe 1.5 cups of the wattle seed. And then obviously just the native flour. So we should get about 10 or 12. All right, so we've just basically finished. They're all ready for the oven. There's how many, mate?
16.
So we've got 16 scones there, ready to go. We're going to put them in for about 15 to 20 minutes. What do you put it down to? About 175 degrees. Okay, we're going to watch them for about 10 to 15 minutes and pull them out once they start to darken in colour. We'll get that nice rise. One of the most important things about cooking is what?
Cleaning.
So we're going to clean up while the scones are in the oven. Okay. It's a perfect time to clean up your kitchen or your workstation while the product's in there cooking. All right. So we're going to go ahead and do that now. All right. And we'll see how we go. Sound good?
So we're all done making our native scones and they're really hot. So we've got to wait 5 minutes for them to cool down.
Awesome. Sound good?
Uh-huh.
How do they smell?
Lovely.
Lovely?
Mm-hmm.
They look all right, don't they? They're a bit brown, okay? So obviously with the wattle in there, that's darken the colour up. It's also some of that medicinal bush, that emu bush. So we'll let them sit, as May said, let them cool down, and then we'll tackle them with a bit of butter. Sound good?
Honey.
Honey, all of it. All right, check it out. Thanks, guys. See you later.